Hi, so in order to get this project started, we need a couple of things. First one, what we require for a speaker is the actual speakers. This is the 4 ohm 3 watt speakers, what I have got, and an amplifier for this, PAM 8403 I think. The links for all these products are there in the description of this video. So after this, some kind of a stereo cable, a small multi-purpose PCB board, a USB hub, very cheap one is enough, you don't need some kind of an expensive stuff. And then what I have got here is the micro USB male, 3 double pole double throw switches and 1 micro USB female port here. And apart from that, couple of wires, and this is very important, USB audio converter. A multimedia remote. So without any further delay, let's get started. So let me just take you through the circuit what I have made. So what you have here is the USB hub, the micro USB male A adapter, the micro USB female, 2 DPDT switches, a general purpose PCB here, the audio amplifier, 2 speakers, and this one is the IR receiver and the USB sound card. So how the wiring has been done is, the green wire, the D plus from the USB hub, goes into the pole position of one of the switches. On one of the ways or one of the ends here, it goes to the USB male A, and the other one goes to the USB micro USB female here. And then actually this wire is supposed to be white. Since the background is white, I have made this wire to be yellow. So what you are then doing is, you are interconnecting all the other wires, the white, red and black, on the general purpose PCB. And here on the switch over here, you have the ground from the micro USB male A and the ID pin from micro USB male A as well. This is essentially the same male A that has been shown differently, with 3 pins on one side and 2 pins on the other. So what happens when you throw the switch this side, the pole positions here, the USB hub's data plus gets connected to data plus of the micro USB A male A, and ID pin gets connected to the ground here. So what essentially happens is, the hub gets connected to the micro USB male A. So when you throw the switch on the other side, the D plus of the hub gets connected to the D plus of your USB female A. So what essentially happens is, your hub directly gets connected to the micro USB female port. And then this connection is fairly simple. You are just taking out the power lines from the board to power your amplifier and the 2 speakers. Here what I have done is, I have taken the power and the ground given to the pole, and then left one of the ways vacant, and the other one is connected to the board over here. So essentially what happens, the interconnection between the power supplies, the VCC and the ground, take place on the board. The VCC and the ground comes from the switch. So this acts like your main power switch. If you turn this off, your amplifier gets turned off. But when your switch goes into the OTG mode, your amplifier gets powered from your Android device. So when you want to connect to your computer, you just turn the switch on the power from the amplifier gets its power from the micro USB female, and since that all the power lines are shorted, your device also gets charged. So this is how the system basically works.
I have got a box which is going to house this two speakers. I have made holes already, and then I doubt if you could see here, I just made a small cut for the micro USB male A, and then a hole here to house the knob for the PAM or the audio amplifier. And at the back here I have got a hole here for one of the power switches, and this will be the input, the micro USB female, and here a hole for two of the DPDT switches. So let us get started and start assembling the stuff. So the entire setup is ready. As you can see, I have got the USB sound converter here. I have got the infrared receiver here, and everything is hooked up. So it's time to close this.
So this is how the final dock looks like. I have added some finishing touches to it. And before you can start using your dock, you need to enable audio through USB in your Android device. So let me just show you as to how it must be done.
Go into settings. If you have your developer options, it is fine. If not, then go into about phone, scroll down to build number. Keep clicking on it until it says you are now a developer. Now go back to the previous page. Now you can see the developer options. Open the developer options and scroll down and choose select USB configuration. If you see here, there is a list of options like charging, MTP, PTP, RN, DIS, audio source and MIDI. So you can choose audio source. So that is it, guys. So that is how you can enable audio through USB in your Android device. So I hope this is informative and useful, and if you feel so, please subscribe for more such videos. Thank you.
So that is it, guys. So that is how you get the dock for your Android device. What it can do is it can charge while you use it as a speaker for your computer, and it can play standalone. It can also play music from your Android device. I hope this project was useful and informative, and if you feel so, please subscribe for more such videos. Thank you.